Dave Ramsey and VA Loans. So for a lot of people who follow me, I'm sure you guys are expecting a very spicy video where I say everything he says is wrong. That's not what I'm gonna say at all. So here's something to think about. I am a mortgage lender. Right now, 50% of my business is VA and 50% of my business is conventional. I have my hand very firmly entrenched in both worlds, so I have a good idea of the pros and the cons of both. Now, do I agree with Dave? Would I put VA and FHA in the same category? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. You can't put them in the same category. VA, if you did 100% financing, there is no mortgage insurance. FHA, you're putting some money down, you're paying mortgage insurance. If you're doing, 3.5% down, you're gonna have mortgage insurance on that loan for the life of the loan or until you refinance. Okay? Those are different ball games. Those should not be in the same world. It's also very different in terms of qualifications. A lot of people assume FHA borrowers and VA borrowers are the same. They are not. They are not. Generally with FHA, I'm going to see lower credit scores, higher debt to incomes, or a past blemish, which is making it so we're going FHA. It is not my first choice, ever. Okay, if someone qualifies for conventional, I'm gonna do conventional over FHA every single day of the week. Is FHA bad? No, but it is more expensive than conventional. It's also more expensive than VA. These two should not exist in the same world. So anytime anyone is comparing VA to FHA, if you're talking to a lender and they're trying to say they're the same, I want you guys to hang up because they don't know what they're talking about. Okay, so that's the first thing. First of all, because he'll say, oh, these two loans, and he keeps on lumping them together, and he's even said, the only person that would use VA is someone who can't afford to do something else, which is not true either. So let's talk about some of the stuff he says that makes sense and some of the stuff that he says that doesn't make sense. Now, here's something for you guys to keep in mind, and you really have to follow Dave Ramsey to, understand that what he preaches and what he talks about is very linear, okay? It is put as much down, your housing costs shouldn't be that much, get a 15-year mortgage. His goal is for you to get into a house and pay it off as quick as possible. In his perfect world, you don't even have a mortgage, okay? He's not taking into consideration market appreciation. He's not taking into consideration equity gain. He's not taking into consideration a starter home. He's not taking into consideration building a real estate portfolio. None of that is being taken into consideration. It is as much down, 15-year note, pay it off, okay? Okay, there's nothing wrong with that. It's very linear. The world I work in is not linear. There's this and this. What about this? Oh, wait, think of that and that and this, okay? So in a world where you're doing more than 20% down and you have very good credit and you're looking at a 15-year mortgage, would I be putting you in VA or conventional? Depends. So if you have to pay the funding fee because you are not exempt, I would be looking at conventional. If you were exempt from the funding fee, if you have some level of disability, then I would be looking at both. And I would be comparing where we were with rates, which one had the least fees, and I would be seeing which one's the best option for you. Okay? Okay, that's fair, right? Okay, so let's talk about the funding fee, because in the videos, Dave's always saying it's the most expensive loan and there's all these gotcha fees. I don't know what the gotcha fees are. This stuff is very easy to find. You can Google, let's do it together, VA funding fee 2021, and there's a chart online that tells you exactly how much the VA funding fees are. So as I film this video, first time use is 2.3%. If you put 5% down, it drops to 1.65%. If you put 10% down, it drops to 1.4%. Okay. Now, if I was comparing that to a conventional loan, VA has no mortgage insurance. Conventional loans have mortgage insurance if you're putting less than 20% down. If you're talking to a lender that says, oh, well, we don't have mortgage insurance, they're just building it in the rate. So you're looking at a no mortgage insurance product with really great rates versus a product that has mortgage insurance. Okay. Now with conventional, you can pay for the mortgage insurance up front in a lump sum. That is an option, but it's not as cheap as those funding fees at the percentages I just described. It's not. VA is cheaper. It's cheaper. Let me say that again. It's cheaper. Yeah. I mean, between the rate and the way the mortgage insurance works, VA is cheaper. Okay. Now, if it's your subsequent use using VA, the funding fee jumps. It goes to 3.6%. The only time I really recommend, you know, doing that is if you're doing 100% financing, or if like your credit's not that great. If you're doing 5% conventional and your credit's 620, your mortgage insurance is going to be incredibly expensive. Your rate's going to be a lot higher. Whereas with VA, you're still going to get a great rate. Would in a perfect world, do I think it's great to do 5% down to drop that 3.6 to 1.65? Yes, but we don't live in a perfect world. Okay, now something else that he brought up is never buy near the base in many cases, because he was saying that areas that rely on the base as their only employment have harder times of appreciation. Okay. I mean, it's 2021, everything's appreciated. So I do think 2020 is a one-off. Do I think that base towns don't appreciate? No, because I think what a lot of people have figured out is that if you buy near base, you have guaranteed renters. Yes, and with the military, if those renters don't pay, you can hold their feet to the fire. Unlike you can do with civilians, you have way more control as a landlord if you have military tenants. Great, wonderful. So what we see a lot of, and what he doesn't really, you know, address is I'll see someone where maybe they're stationed in Texas and they'll buy a house for a couple $100,000. Then they PCS to North Carolina and they buy another house. The one in Texas, they may not be selling. They may be turning it into a rental property. They may be using their VA entitlement in North Carolina as well, because you can have more than one VA loan as long as you have eligibility. Yeah, I have seen people who have three to four, and I'm like, wow. And you know, they basically, and a lot of them, it was before housing prices went up dramatically, but every place they went, they would buy a house and then they'd be renting it out like to buddies after they left, and they have a real estate portfolio from that. So VA can be great from that. Can you use it to be like, oh, I want to buy an investment property in Maine? I mean, I don't know why I picked Maine, but no, you can't do that. VA loans are meant to be owner-occupied for at least the first 12 months. Now, if you live there while you're serving on that base and then you get PCS'd, that's fine. You can turn it into an investment property. You don't have to redo the mortgage. You can keep that beautiful low rate you already have. So overall, you know, do I think Dave's wrong? I don't think in the case that he's thinking about, he is. You know, if you're doing a huge down payment, if you're going for a 15-year fixed, if you've got good credit because you paid, you know, off your debt, conventional may be the better option, especially if you have to pay the funding fee. But if you don't have to pay the funding fee, it's an equal ball game. And that's what's so important to remember, guys, is that your individual scenario is unique. And there's no one answer on does VA make sense, is VA good, or is VA bad, without taking into account your personal situation. So I do think it's important that when you guys are looking at these options, you know, I am very pro VA, but I also have a good foothold in conventional. So I can really weigh out, does this make sense? Does this not make sense? And what you see a lot of is you'll see on YouTube VA lenders who say, it's always VA, VA always wins. Not accurate. not 100% accurate for every situation. So it's important that instead of taking one person's opinion on, is it the best loan? Is it a bad loan? You talk to a lender who deals with the two worlds of loans that you're looking at every single day so that they can talk you through the questions to help you make the best choice for you. So I hope this has been helpful. As always, questions or comments, please leave them below.